Hi, I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, president of the Florida Society of Neurology and medical director of Neurologique in Ponte Vedra, Florida. Here at the Consortium of MS Centers annual meeting, we got to meet somebody named Dr. Bob Fox, and he talked to us about something called NARCOMS. Well, we're really lucky to actually be joined here by many other doctors and other investigators who have to do with this idea called NARCOMS. And we're going to be asking them things like, what do you think people should know about NARCOMS, and what do you want to tell patients back home? So I'm joined here by Dr. Stacey Corfield of NARCOMS, who's actually the deputy director of the NARCOMS Coordinating Center, and she's associate professor of biostatistics at UAB, so University of Alabama at Birmingham. So I want to thank you so much for joining us. What would you want people back home to know about NARCOMS, and what can they know about what happens here at the consortium?
Well, first of all, I'd like to start by thanking all of the over 37,000 people with MS. Correct. Yeah, we are the largest patient-supported registry of MS in the world right now. And so that's a huge thank you directly to the participants that have already contributed. And what we'd like to do is to continue to build our participant base so that we can get a good cross-section or actually expand our demographics of the people that we see. The reason that that's very important is that everybody's very familiar with clinical trial results. Right. When they come out, they make big splash. Mm-hmm. The problem is the trials usually only follow people for 2 to 3 years, and right. usually in the early stages of MS. Mm-hmm. But as we know, MS is a long-term disease. Okay. The importance of NARCOMS is the longitudinal or long-term follow-up, to follow people throughout the whole course.
Following throughout time. Kind
of. Yes, and that's really important in terms of once people really settle into their disease course or get treated or have changes to their lifestyle, if they stop working or if they change medications, what happens to them then?
So if somebody moves or they get a new neurologist, does that mean they can still be part of NARCOMS, or what happens then?
Absolutely. NARCOMS is largely about 2/3 of our participants fill out their surveys online.
Okay.
And we have more people switching to online every day. And so anywhere in the world, in fact, 3% of our NARCOMS participants are outside of the United States.
Oh, wow.
We are fully available in Spanish as well, and we would really like to expand globally so that we have a more universal picture of what happens to people with MS.
Wow. So once again, if you want to get involved in research where it doesn't mean you have to be in a clinical trial, getting a medicine, sometimes feeling like what we call a guinea pig, if you want to get involved with adding to the information we understand about the long term, then get involved with NARCOMS. Thank you so much for joining
Thank
us.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.